Alright everybody, what is up? It's the Odd Programmer here, and today we are going to look at the Android Jetpack's paging library. So let's get started. Consider a scenario where you have a large list of something and want to show it in recycler view. Loading the list into memory and putting it there will be a costly process. So the solution to this is the lazy loading, and Jetpack's paging library does the same. It loads the data in small chunks and loads those particular chunks which are required to show on the screen. So if your application has to show a large list, then you should definitely use the paging library. So enough with the theory now, let's get started. For this tutorial, we will integrate the paging library in the restaurant simulator application, which we made in the MVVM series. You can check out the MVVM tutorial series, the link will be given in the description. So first of all, let's clone the paging setup branch of the restaurant simulator's GitHub repository. I have done some modifications like updated the build.gradle file and rectified one mistake from the last video of the MVVM series. So after cloning, import it into Android Studio. So first of all, open up the main activity file and scroll down to setup views function, and you can see that I have changed it to refer the views via the binding object. Earlier we were referring to them via find view by ID. According to the Android's developer website, we should refer the views via the binding object if we are using either data binding or view binding. We did it via find view by ID and got away with, but we shouldn't do that as it may or might lead to some errors. One more thing here that I added is this data Kotlin file, which contains an array list of predefined order objects, which will be useful for the later part of this tutorial. So I really appreciate you to clone or download the project from GitHub. So anyway, let's focus on paging now. Paging is all about page list, which is a class capable of loading data into chunks or pages. As new data is required, it is loaded into the existing page list object. So first of all, open the order.dao file and make this getAllOrders function return this data source.factory type instead of live data of list of orders. In order to get a page list object, we need this data source.factory because data source is responsible for loading pages for a page list object, whereas the factory class is responsible for updating the page list object whenever there is any change in the underlying data source. Plus, there are three types of data source. You can head over to the developer site to read more about them. The one we will use is this last one called positional data source. Positional data source uses int as the key type. Key is required to differentiate between different items and different pages in page list. Second, for the value type we are passing our order class. So that's it for this class now. Next, open the repository class and edit this allOrders function. Change the return type to live data of page list of orders. As you can see, it is getting the data source.factory from the DAO interface and then call this toLiveData function on it to convert it into live data of page list. We are passing in our custom configuration object. As you can see, we have set the page size to 10, which means that every chunk size or page size of the page list will be this large. Next is enable placeholders, which is set to false. This helps to show a placeholder object in case of data that is yet to be loaded. Last is max size, which means the maximum amount of object to be stored in the page list at once. Once this threshold is exceeded, page list starts to replace the older data with newer ones. Here max size is set to 50. So that's all for this class now. Next, we will have to modify our adapter class to use the paged list. So open the order adapter file. First of all, make this class extend paged list adapter instead of recycler view adapter. Paged list adapter listens to paged list loading callbacks to update the recycler view. As you can see here, it takes in diff util item callback in the constructor. So we pass in one. We have this static object of diffUtilItemCallback of type order here, which we are passing to the constructor. Next, as you may have noticed, we have removed the list of order which you have in your version because we already passed in the type to our page list adapter here and it manages the list itself. So remove the orders list variable plus remove the get item count override method as it is already implemented by the page list adapter itself. Next, edit the onBindViewHolder function. We are using this getItem function here, which is provided by the page list adapter to get the item at a certain position. Finally, remove the setOrders function which you have in your file as we don't need it anymore, and you will see that in a minute. I already have it removed. So that's all for the adapter file. Next, open the main activity file and here in the live data's observe callback where we are setting the new list to the adapter, remove the setOrders function as we removed it. Instead, we will use submitList function which is provided by the PageList adapter to submit a new or updated list. So that's all for the paging library, it is done. You can go ahead and run the application. If everything is done right, the application will run without any problem. Now, if you remember, we have this data file here which contains some predefined data. We need to add a method to insert this large dummy data, then only having the paging library will make sense. So let's go ahead and do that. In our implementation, we will add the option to insert dummy data in the app bar's overflow menu. So first of all, create a new Android resource directory of type menu. Under menu, create a new menu XML file and name it appbar_menu. Create an item with ID action_fill. Set its title to something like this, which will make sense. Last, for show as action attribute, set it to never to show this option only in the overflow menu. Next, edit the main activity layout file and set the toolbar menu to the one we just created. So we are done with the layout part. Next, we need to add some methods on the backend part to make it work. So first of all, open the order DAO file and create another insert function that takes in a list of orders. Next, open the repository file and create another insert order suspend function which inserts the list of orders. Do the same thing with view model. Next, open the main activity file and set the callback for menu item click listener. We set the view models insert method and pass in our dummy data. So that completes the insert dummy data functionality too. Now go ahead and run the application. You will see the option to fill data and when you tap on it, the data will be added to the database and will be shown in the recycler view. So that's all for this video. I hope you learned something good today. Good luck for the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe and turn on the notification bell. This is the Odd Programmer signing out.